fazer esse projeto, surgiu um Trancoso, um festival que eu sou meio curador, meio diretor de uma noite lá e tal. Em Trancoso, chama Música em Trancoso, MET. É um festival muito bonito, onde o objetivo principal desse festival é divulgar o máximo possível às pessoas, ao povo comum, às pessoas, principalmente de lá mesmo, do sul da Bahia, da região e tudo mais, a cultura da música erudita.
O César fez o dia dele de música popular, sucesso estrondoso, e aí resolvemos fazer o tal do Jam Session, colocando os alemães e outros junto com os brasileiros para tocar juntos música popular brasileira.
I will never forget our first encounter as we were supposed to make a first rehearsal for the so-called jam session. And we were just waiting for César and really waiting for a teacher, for someone who's going to tell us how to make Brazilian music, how to play. And instead of saying something, besides, of course, saying hello, how's everybody? But he was just sitting down and starting to play the piano. And after a couple of minutes, his Brazilian musicians started to play with him. And it became some kind of a gig, and it was just wonderful. And we were inspired by that. And all of a sudden, 10, 15 minutes later, everybody, one after the other, started to play without knowing what we were playing, just participating. And César stopped after 1 hour and saying, well, that's it.
De um dia pro outro, ficou todo mundo amigo. Não só nossos amigos da banda e tal, como entre eles. Porque tinha gente ali que sabia do outro, mas nunca tinha conversado. Nesse caso nosso aqui, o flautista, o Benoit, conheceu os outros dois lá em Trancoso. Nunca tinham estado juntos também. E a proximidade ficou um pouco maior entre mim, Benoit, Walter e o Rudiger. As mulheres estavam lá. Aí ficaram amigas, as mulheres ficaram amigas entre elas. Tinha filhos, ficaram amigos também. Então, só que virou uma família assim, de repente, rapaz, do dia para a noite.
First, we were very impressed, you know, to play with César. We're just coming from this classical world, which is. And what we have, I have to say that there's a big difference what I knew from Europe. And then what I feel, maybe it's unique with César, but we have a lot of, how can I say, in Europe, prejudgment. So when you see someone, you can already say, oh, it's very, with a lot of criticism. You know, it's always not so positive. It's always, okay, it's like this, it looks like this, or it do like this. So also, but also for the music, okay, you are classical, musician, so you cannot play jazz or blah blah, or you are a flutist, so you cannot be a conductor. You know that the same way. And we were not, of course, we were a little bit scared of that because, but that was the opposite. So we were a little bit shy to play the things and said, don't worry, music is music. You know, you do the thing with your quality, your defaults, and just go on and then we see, it was the smile like this, like till the ears, you know. And okay, that was like, welcome guys, just play. And that's why this way to give confidence, it's amazing because you, and then you can just follow what he gave from the information about the music, and that's it.
Mas da turma toda, o que mais ficou junto, assim, quem mais ficou mais junto, foram eles três com a gente. E do nível, assim, tipo, Logo depois do festival, já tinha e-mail em casa, a caixa cheia de e-mail dos caras. Falando como é que foi a viagem e tal, não sei o quê. Quer dizer, pintou essa amizade, enfim. E na minha cabeça começou a ficar muito mais forte a possibilidade desse negócio do crossover, desse mix musical entre os dois mundos, entre os dois universos. Como fazer, eu ainda não sabia, mas eu queria fazer.
2 years ago, I never forget that César had the idea to come together more and to really working on a new project. And then he wrote us, the name will be Joint. And that was fantastic. And for my vision of music, it's so great that I have the opportunity to get in something after a long, long term of lifetime with classical, great conductors, wonderful musicians, but never in touch with such a nice feeling that I can learn something new. Absolute from the beginning, with an open mind and with a lot of respect.
Eu tinha de um lado a informação erudita. Informação. Então eu peguei. Você ouvir. Eu naturalmente eu ouço muita música clássica. Mais especificamente de 3 anos para cá, mergulhei de cabeça. Então fiquei ouvindo muito isso. E não só Villa-Lobos, porque o Villa-Lobos já tem uma ponte direta com a gente, né? Com a gente, com a música brasileira contemporânea, ele já tem uma ponte, porque ele é brasileiro. Camargo Guarnieri é outra ponte também, porque é brasileiro. Mas e Stravinsky, e Debussy, e Sibelius, e Bach, Beethoven, Mozart? Ficava feio. Ficava... Na minha cabeça, particularmente, ficava até desrespeitoso. Sabe, ficar mexendo nessas coisas. Eu falei, bom, não é, definitivamente não é por aí. Eu tenho que compor nesse formato. Então, fechei as portas de tudo que estava acontecendo e comecei a pensar só nisso. E cheguei num ponto legal na composição. Na composição e no formato. O formato teria que ser isso, um combo pop, jazz pop, bossa nova, pop, jazz, uma coisa assim, isso aqui embaixo. Enfim, o que eu sempre fiz na minha vida, eu aqui com meu piano e o quarteto, teclados, não sei o quê, e solistas. Mas os solistas não podiam simplesmente tocar as melodias. Tinha que estar integrado no arranjo, com vozes, com fazendo base para um solo de piano, fazendo base para um solo de guitarra, ao mesmo tempo que a gente fazendo base para um solo, para solos deles. Então, temas e solos, esses solos todos escritos, evidentemente, mas para que eles, falando em termos musicais, para que eles swingassem o ritmo proposto, eu tive que arranjar um jeito diferente de escrever para eles, sem muita síncope, sem muito uma forma erudita de escrever para eles entenderem, para eles tocarem esse samba, vamos dizer assim.
We have a special feeling and a special connection to, I would just say, groove, the beat. And this beat is so important throughout a piece that, as a classical musician, I was not really realizing how important and how nice it is to listen to that. And I must say, I learn a lot of things with that. I learn how to keep the rhythm. I learn how to play really on the edge, when you're supposed to play. Of course, in classical music, you have to play together, and we're working all our lifetime on this, because, you know, playing together, that's not just a thing when you say 1, 2, 3, 4, there you play. It's just also, you know, how you feel. If you're in a good shape, if you have a cough, you have a cold, something like this, your reaction will be just a fraction of a second late, and then that's not together. But here, when you continue to play on a rhythm, then it's so important, and you get it, and you get it, and you get it. And that's what I learn about this music. And very often, my impression is that the Brazilian typical rhythm, which I hear from the bossa nova jazz, is some kind of, you know, this kind of laziness, but it's so precise at the same time. And that's what I would say is something new to me. To play on that, particularly a long line, which you can play on a flute, which you can play on the clarinet, but also on the violin, to play a long line on that, that is so amazing, because you feel yourself just lifted by the rhythm, by the harmonies, by the guitar, by the drums, by the bass player, and of course of César, who is accompanying. New world, new dimension for us. And that's, I'm very grateful for this.
This is very interesting because, of course, César, he's used to his classical Brazilian jazz. But now he's going also in the way of the also the classical music and the crossover thing, but with his fantastic tastes as fantastic musician. So he has the, I think for him also that's, he discover things about himself, about the way he can produce different things, I mean produce in terms of writing music. And this kind of crossover, I don't know if crossover, we say, you know, you have to make stems for everything, but it's just music. And this arrangement he did for the whole group here is just good music. There's only good music, you know, like we can say it. But it's a fantastic work and very interesting about the sounds, because it's related to every kind of music. It could be Debussy, Ravel, sometimes also jazz, Jobim or whatever, or César. But it's a big, how can I say, rainbow, you know, of music. That's the best feeling. So everything is positive, what can I say? So just we enjoy, and that's a privilege to be a musician, to have some such encounter with people like César, and privilege to play with him, and to have the honor to play with him, and to share these emotions.
It's really something for me new, the first time to build a recording in different cases together. As a classical musician, you are not used to play your part first with a small group, and then later it will be mixed and it will be one project. So this is something new, but I like the way how it's done here so professionally. And it's lucky that we have time. First of all, there is not a hurry. There are not, normally I'm used to recording sessions which are ending after 3 hours and that's it. And when you're in the end of the day, you're not finished, you have a bad feeling, but the sound engineer has to go, everybody has to go. And there is no time. Here in this week, a wonderful week in the Mosh Studios here in São Paulo, we can come together and we can learn together and we can really growing up as a new ensemble. That I love.
Esse quarteto, o Thiago Rabelo, o Cidiel Vieira e o Conrado Góes e eu, a gente tem um quarteto, né, acústico, e a gente tem rodado por aí e tal. Então, desde o primeiro dia, desde a primeira vez que eu conheci os caras, que eu os conheci, eu propus isso e eles toparam. Então, cada vez que a gente toca junto, cada concerto que a gente faz, tem uma... Acaba ficando, pelo menos para mim, acaba ficando uma coisa muito rica, porque é um outro tipo de informação. Apesar de que Cidiel e o Thiago Rabelo, o baixo e baterista, eles têm um conhecimento jazzístico muito bom,
eles têm uma experiência, de uma certa forma, muito boa da minha música, da música da nossa época, da bossa nova e do jazz. O jazz tradicional, da bossa nova. Tá. Eles têm uma experiência e conhecem muito. Eles só não tocam todo dia, como eu. Mas eles conhecem perfeitamente. Então, só que quando eles vão tocar a bossa nova, vem com um sotaque, sabe, cabelinho raspado aqui, em pezinho e tal. Vem de tênis, né? Eu tô de sapato.
Now we got to the point to make it. It's like a writer, you know. He had the idea, and he wants to write to make the book. So we are starting to make the book now here. So it's a little bit that, but then the book we have to bring to the shops or to the library or to the people. So that's I guess the first. It's the beginning, the first step. And then now we will give what the result of the studio to open our arms. I mean to say, hey guys, we are here. Maybe we can share the fantastic music of César. And go maybe on tour in different places all over the world. That will be the best. Wish I could say tonight.
I would like to say thank you, especially to César and also the quartet, and the young musicians, the bass, the drums, and Conrado as the guitar player. They are really friends, and it's such a pleasure to make music with them. And I know that we're going to meet together again and again and again, because it's going to be in Trancoso again. It's going to be hopefully on tour with this project. And I'm really looking forward to that.
Então, a única esperança e a expectativa é que ele termine, que fique perfeito como a gente está pensando. Da capa à distribuição. Se ele vai ser bem distribuído, se ele vai ter uma sabe, para mim, não está importando. O que está importando é o registro disso. Registro perene diz, entendeu? Não um filminho para passar no YouTube ou ficar rodando no Facebook, na internet ou no Twitter e tal. Uma coisa perene. Agora, o que vai acontecer, a gente tava falando, conversando com eles no carro, indo para o hotel ontem à noite, exatamente isso de, puxa vida, a gente está fazendo uma terceira coisa. Qual público a gente vai atingir? Da música clássica ou da música pop? A gente não sabe. E, na verdade, não importa. Na verdade, não está importando. Está importando é registrar isso. Para mim, particularmente, para mim, está importando registrar uma coisa que eu jamais fiz, que sempre sonhei em fazer, e nunca tive oportunidade de fazer. Eu tive outras grandes oportunidades na vida, mas essa não, essa sempre sonhei.